Great. Good morning, everyone. This is Rick Phillips for CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports. We are live from the campus of Wilmington High School. We have a triple header today. The way that works is we've got three teams. We're going to play three games. Every team will play the other two teams once during this triple header. And we are starting the day off with the Williamsburg Wildcats versus the Wilmington Hurricane.
Yes.
The Wilmington Hurricane have talked about a new league this next year, and one of those leagues that they have discussed is the SBAAC, which Williamsburg is a part of.
Yes.
So we will find out on Monday whether these two teams that are competing this morning for our first game of a triple header are actually going to be league buddies here in this in 2 years, in 2018, with the new season there. We got everything ready. We've got our book ready. Two of the other games that we will have today, we've got, besides the Wildcats of Williamsburg, we have the
Lions of Fairfield.
That's right. And we'll play that second game. That'll be the Leesburg Fairfield Lions. That will also then be the Williamsburg Wildcats for game number two. And then to round out game number three, it will be Leesburg Fairfield, the Lions, versus the Wilmington Hurricane. And that'll wrap up our three games and our Saturday of softball mania here on Campus Nation. Also, we've got a mock NFL draft on TalkTV.us, our other network, that will be on at Generations Pizza from 1 to 4 tomorrow. So all of you sports buffs that can't wait for football season to be back and strong, you might want to tune in or even check out the mock draft on TalkTV.us. That's our special edition of the Sports Planet coming live from Generations Pizza tomorrow starting at 1 o'clock. Actually, we'll probably be on the air a few minutes before that so we can get everybody. There'll be GMs calling in from all over the country representing these various teams and picking the NFL draft choices.
Now, I got to put a shout out already. I might have to do this a couple times today, but our good buddy, the friend, the mayor, the one, the only, the mayor of Greenfield.
Happy birthday.
It's her birthday today.
Happy birthday,
Angie Shiller, over there in Greenfield.
She's 29 years old.
On North Street. Actually, she's, what'd she say she was?
32.
32, that's right. Because she's like 10 years younger than me. I'm not 52 yet, but I'm close. August, I'll be 52. So.
Are you using that Common Core math with your age there, Charlie?
Yes. You know what I think of Common Core? Whoever wrote it, give me the book and I'll use it for toilet paper.
Okay, well, there's his political statement for today.
That's right.
Yeah. And of course,
do I only get one?
No, you can probably, what, three games? I'll give you three statements.
Okay.
There you go.
Sometimes I make them more and realize it.
Well, that's true. You're right. You're right. You make all kinds of statements you don't realize.
I'll tell you what, Target's getting beat on, aren't they?
You mean because of the gender?
Kinds of people on Facebook are like boycotting Target now. I think they may have screwed up.
Well, I think that, you know, politically speaking, there was such a big thing made out of North Carolina and then passing the law, but they say that a new poll has shown that about 73% of the population, they think that males should be in male restrooms and females should be in female restrooms.
Right.
And I didn't see anyone when I went to the restroom here. There was no females in that restroom.
I keep waiting. Ain't that funny? Every time I'm going in, I'm like, well, who's right there? Yeah, here's the thing.
What I'm waiting for is to see one of them use the urinal.
Common sense should take control here. You know what? If you're that way and you won't be that way, that's fine. But guess what? I'm sure in the women's bathrooms, although I've never been in any, but in the men's bathroom, if you want to go, there's always a closed-off area. Just go in a closed-off area, do your business. And then if somebody finds out, well, that's not your problem, that's their problem, because they shouldn't be looking.
Now, as Lee Hindy said yesterday on Facebook, all my bathrooms are unisex anyway. So,
like at home.
Right, we don't have any problem with that. But I've been in many a woman's restroom simply because I've owned so many restaurants and nightclubs and places where I had to
be careful how you say that. Now, folks, we may have a problem today because Roger, even though he is he is our technical flunky. He can see. So down the third base line here at Wilmington High School.
Oh, I can see the third base line.
It's hard to see out left field where we're at. Now, if it gets warmer, I may move outside for the second game. But this first game, my big bet's going to stay right in here.
Yeah, we might even open the window the second game, right?
Well, that's fine. You can open the window if I'm outside. I don't care at that point. All right, starting today for the Williamsburg Wildcats, we have Fisher, who's going to be playing shortstop, Clark playing second, Smith will be batting third and playing center, Wagers will be at first, and let's see, Wagers will be pitching, Gull will be catching, Kirshner will be at first, Ogden will be at third, Tidwell will be in left, and Jeffers is a designated player. For the Hurricane of Wilmington, it's Hunter Toller catching. Chase Hanna will be playing short. Courtney Smart will be left field. Megan Fisher,
Wildcats.
Megan Fisher will be at third, and Jatasia Jones out center. Jalen Hensley is playing short. Jalen Hensley is playing right. Got my numbers dyslexical. Sorry about
that. That's all right, Taylor.
It's early. It's an early day for us.
It's early. You got up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
You know what? I was up at 6 this morning, but then I went back to bed for about an hour.
I get up every morning at 8, whether I need to or not.
Kelsey Bear is at 8. No, she's not. We're playing first. Sherrick McCloskey is the DH today. Matty Flint will be pitching for the Hurricane.
Let me borrow your book.
Okay. Right
here. You have the numbers right on this, right?
Yeah, I hope. Let's hope so.
You can announce it.
Yeah, there you go, Charlie. Your big debut.
Announce their starting lineup.
Okay, starting for Williamsburg, we have Fisher playing short. Clark will be playing second. Smith is in center. Wagers will be pitching. Gullett catching. Kirshner first base. Ogden will be playing third. Tidwell will be playing left. And Jeffers is a designated player with Bowden for out in the field. Okay, for Wilmington, we have Hunter Taylor catching, Hannah Chase playing short, Courtney Smart playing left field, Megan Fisher playing third, Jatasia John center field, Jalen Hensley right field, Lila Self second base, Kelsey Bear first base, Cherokee McCloskey is the designated player, and Matty Flint is your pitcher today.
Yeah,
there you go, Charlie. Your major league debut.
Doing both.
You are infamous now.
I feel like the little kid at the Reds game who gets to do one of the innings.
Except that you're a lot older than the little kid, Charlie.
I'm a lot bigger.
Well, I didn't go there.
I'll go there. It's okay.
Yeah, all right.
I can handle criticism. Actually, I like criticism.
You're good at that, Charlie. I got to say, the many broadcasts that we've done together, I've thrown a little your way, and you've taken it all. So you're almost as good as Dave, not quite. Well, we do have the benefit of being in a booth, so the windows are closed, and right now...
No wind right now.
That's right. The wind is probably the killer on this. We've got a beautiful day for softball.
Oh, it is.
And, of course, you know, the ladies, they've got these uniforms on that I think probably protect them from a lot of the wind, maybe. And I don't know. Does that... Is like a spandex or lycra or...
They're a nylon polyester blend.
And so does it go through? Does the air go through? Oh, that's not good.
Days like today, wear something underneath.
Yeah, so you'd have like I don't know what that would be, long johns or something like that.
That or Under Armour stuff. I tell you, I've got something on underneath. I got a long sleeve shirt on, and I had my shorts all out.
And you're wearing your Kevlar vest, aren't you?
Yeah, I need to.
Yeah, right.
That's true.
Because you're a Trump supporter.
That's true, baby. Blue Trump. Now you brought that up, not me.
We'll see.
That's your political comment for the day.
That's right.
But you know what, folks, whoever wins this election. We need to get behind them. But I tell you what, the thing that worries all of us, I think, is we just question whether our elections are even fair anymore.
Well, the most important thing is we all are concerned about our kids and our grandkids, and whatever or whoever is elected, we just want things to be positive. positive. We want people to work together, and we want to go forward.
There you go. That's the key, whoever's in there, because right now, no one works together.
Well, the Cane are taking the field, so we're going to get this event underway. The Wildcats of Williamsburg and the Hurricane of Wilmington. Game one of a triple header here on CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports.
Now, can you tell looking at that screen right now whether we're on or not?
Well, I know we're on, but I've got to come up here and actually...
All you new listeners from Williamsburg, check us out here, Campus Nation.
We invite everybody. And as I said, we'll know Monday, but it appears that Wilmington will probably be a new entrant to your league, along with Clinton Massey and the East Clinton Astros. I'm wearing red black today. Of course, I always do that because it's Campus Nation colors.
Well, it'd be nice to get some Campus Nation shirts, maybe some hoodies.
Well, give me some. Give me some. Get my name on it.
Well, Travis will do it for you. I got to ask him.
Well, I probably have to pay him, too. See, that's the big thing, Charlie.
Well, that's all right.
If you can give me some exchange for advertising stuff.
He'll advertise. He'll cut you a deal. I bet he'd sell it to you. Everything it costs, he'd advertise for him.
Yeah, that might work.
I bet he would.
Yeah.
All right, nice throw down there.
If I could go to Target and buy it.
I'm going to tell now. I don't think I could ever. I never get the Target thing's not a big deal to me anyhow, because we don't have a Target real close. Oh, you can go to Target.
Right, yeah, you're at Walmart.
The one time I go to Target is when somebody gives me a gift card for it. I go in there and spend about 10 minutes.
I get a Target card, but I don't use it that often.
Starting off the lineup was number 20.
Fisher.
All right.
Oh, she's playing 6. All right, got it.
Fisher is her name. All right, here we go. Ready to go. Live action here. Got left-handed Fisher up to the bat. Pitching for Wilmington is Maddie Flint. And the first pitch is in, and it's hit right back up the middle in the center field for a base hit.
Nice knock there.
First pitch hitting.
Next at bat for Williamsburg, number 23, Clark.
And that was a nice shot right back up
perfect.
The middle.
Absolutely perfect. Seeing eye.
Third baseman's playing way in. Second baseman's playing way in. Squares the bunt. Foul ball. Foul off a leg to Clark. So you got like that. First two pitches. First two batters are swinging.
They're aggressive. No question about it.
Runner's going. It's drilled past third. Base hit. Two base hits in a row here by the Williamsburg Wildcats. They're playing in for a bunt, and Clark took advantage of it. Drilled it right past the third baseman.
Number one, batting for Williamsburg, Casey Smith.
Smith coming up. Big old tall girl here. Williamsburg's got the first two on quickly. Nice leads by each runner. Everybody's playing back here. No one's playing up. I figure these girls probably going to be swinging away anyhow. I doubt that Wilmington's played Williamsburg this year, so it's kind of like not sure, you know, what to expect. Pitches in there, fouled off. And like Rick said, these guys are probably the same league, but I think they'll be in different divisions.
Small division, probably.
Yeah, Williamsburg's playing the small school division, and Wilmington will be in the big school division, I am assuming. Now, I have no idea on that. Squares bunt, runner's going from second to third. That's turned into the outfield, but she's going to hold her at third as Wilmington left fielder is backing up.
So both runners are moving up.
So, we got two balls, one strike on the batter. Runners at second and third now. Ball's low. Stayed right there. Got by the catcher, Toler, but hit the umpire, so no one advances. Three balls, one strike. Glad you're joining us today on CampusNation.com. Change up, strike two. Nice pitch by Maddie Flint.
Hurricane need an out here.
Yep, full count. Pitch is on his way. And it's low for ball four. Ball gets away. No one's covering the plate. And runner scores easily.
First blood, but Williamsburg takes the lead with a 1-0 lead right now here in the top of the first. Definitely not wasting any time.
Nope. So, 1-0, nobody out. Wagers is at bat. Big old tall left-hander here. There's a first and third. She scores the bunt. The ball goes to second. They should have her if they called her out. Yeah, they called her out trying to steal second, but the runner comes in from third to score, so it's 2-0, but Wilmington does get an out. I like to see that. They threw through there. Even though the run scores, it's early in the game. So one out, one strike on the batter. Base is empty now, but two runs in. One ball, one strike here. A big tall Wagers, the cleanup hitter for the Wildcats. 2-0. Pitch is on its way. Hit right to the first baseman, and she will be out. Two outs. Two outs going, coming up the bat.
Up to the plate, Morgan Gullett, number 16.
So nobody on base, two runs in, two outs. Gullett at the plate, and front pitching. Pitch was ball. Williamsburg's going to be feeling pretty good about themselves. Got two runs here in the first inning. Uh-oh, ball's hit hard. Is it gone?
Yeah,
gone.
It is. Oh.
No, oh my.
Yeah,
oh my.
It's gone.
I saw the umpire put his hand up. See, we're blind to that right here. We're right in his booth.
Yeah, the third baseline is not the greatest view.
Go at homers over the left field wall.
Some power there. So it's 3-0.
Number 19, Michaela Kirshner.
Here came up with two outs, so maybe they would be able to stop the bleeding. But
take go, it just drilled out. I thought it was gone when it left the bat, but it went out of my view. If you can kind of picture where we're at here, and you'll see it when you're on, when you see the video. The video, by the way, will be live tomorrow, and we're like on the third base line, and we got a nice big window, but then to our left, it's just concrete walls, so it's hard for us to see
through the concrete.
Yes. I don't have my Superman powers yet.
My X-ray vision.
Yeah.
Spidey.
Yeah. My A vision.
You just need normal vision. That would be nice, right?
One ball, no strikes to Kirshner.
What a swing.
Yeah, they're going big down there in Williamsburg. This is a big old tall. Well, she's not real tall, I guess. She looked taller than what she did a minute ago. Well, she's pretty tall.
She is tall.
I think the umpire's a little short. I think that's making her a little...
Is that it? Okay, well, we'll say that.
No offense to the umpire. Nice pitch there, but called the ball. Two balls, one strike, Kirshner. Strike two. And I want to say big. I'm talking about tall.
She looks like she could jack the ball, too.
The last four have. I tell you what, Smith, Wagers, Gullett, Kirshner, they're all. They look like they all mean business. Ball's hit. We'll change that pitch. Hits the first baseman, and they get the out at first.
All right.
So ground out from the pitcher to the first baseman. And that's three outs, but three runs in for the Williamsburg Wildcats. On one, two, three hits and a walk.
at bat for Wilmington. They start off this inning.
Wilmington did have an error that inning. And nobody's left on base.
Now, games that we've done prior, Charlie, Wilmington's always gotten the first runs and gotten off to a good start. So maybe this is good voodoo here.
So much just depends on pitching in softball, Rick. I mean, if the pitcher, you know, it's like a Clint Massey, or my goodness. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, let's hope she gets back to playing.
Well, and that girl for Hillsborough, she got off to a bit of a rough start, but after she calmed down,
was that the one that's called Cleveland State?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it looks like the Fairfield Lions are coming in to watch a little bit of this first game. Their bus is rolling down the road. And they're tough. I saw in the paper, I think they've only lost two all year. And I would almost bet that they're probably, I think that's the Southern Hills League you're in. I would almost bet they're probably on top of it. They've got a good coach there, Mark Detweiler. I used to coach with him over at Greenfield.
So they actually came to Four Peace, huh?
No, Leesburg.
Oh, Leesburg.
Yeah, Leesburg. No, they didn't come very far though. Williamsburg, now that's a little hike down there.
Yeah, but we'll have to go that direction if we're in that league, especially if we're in the same division.
And the worst part about that league is just to get there from Wilmington, there's no good way. I mean, you either got to do 71 down 275 or 28.
We can take my chopper.
Yeah, we might need to.
We'll just go in with the chopper.
I need whoever that is
to
slip by right there.
Okay, here we go. She needs whoever that is to slip by. Hunter Toler up to plate. Wow, this Williamsburg's left-handed wager. She's got some speed, folks.
Was that a strike?
Yeah, strike. Swinging strike. Whoever the deal was just walked by. Next pitch, I think it's in there for strike also. Kind of got blocked out there. Yep, no balls, two strikes to Taylor.
Trying to figure out our music, maybe.
Ball. One ball, two strikes. Here's Wager. She's got the mask on out there, big left-hander. And I tell you what, she's firing. She got some good speed.
Well, hopefully the team can get on the board here, come back and maybe
strike three.
Tie it up or go ahead.
Hunter Toler strikes out. Probably was ball two. It was a pretty high pitch she swung at there. But I tell you what, when you got a fast pitcher, I guess you got to make your mind up quick. Hannah Chase. From the bat, left-hander, and she's way up in the box. I'd tell him to be scooting back in the box against her. Nice pitch, a little outside, look like. Fouled off. Got a piece of it, did Chase. This girl looks like about the fastest we've seen pitch down here. What do you think?
It's a baller. That's a strike.
It's a ball and strike.
Does look pretty fast.
One ball, two strikes. It's another high strike. Wonderful swinging there. They're helping her out. They're swinging a lot of high pitches. Ball's hit down the first base line and foul. Strike three.
Ooh.
So, Wager starting out with two straight strikeouts here against the Cane. And Courtney Smart coming to the bat. First pitch swinging, strike. Got a little bit of a change right off on that one. Hit to the third baseman, throw on the first, and that's three outs. Ground out, third to first. Kane up and down quickly here in the first inning. This Wagers, folks, she's got a nice little fastball. If I'm coaching Wilmington right now, I got to tell them, get back in the box. I also need to tell them, don't necessarily swing those high pitches. They gave her two or three of them that inning that, would have been called balls. Looks like Ogden, Tidwell, and Jeffers coming up. And then we'll start the top of the order again because that last one's the flex. Ogden, Tidwell, and Jeffers will be leading off. So 7-8-9 for Williamsburg. Again, if you're listening from Williamsburg today, we appreciate it. Like I said, when Wilmington joins this league down there, you may get a lot more 7-8-9.
I'm off on my count somehow.
Yeah, we'll be doing games from Williamsburg, probably basketball and football. Now, we only do home baseball and softball games here at Wilmington, which there's no baseball game today. It's kind of funny to look up there and not see them playing up there.
Right, yeah. Well, they may be away. I don't know.
Yeah, they were supposed to play last night and got rained out.
Massive was the game.
So we get number 7, Ogden, coming up, the third baseman for Williamsburg. And the pitch by Flint is hit in the center, and it's caught. Nice catch out there by Johns.
She put him right into it.
Yep, first pitch hitting. Well, Wilmington pitcher, she's a good pitcher, Flint, but she doesn't have near the speed. And that's why you're seeing the Williamsburg batter scooting up toward the pitcher.
Rachel Tidwell.
Tidwell at the plate. Tidwell. The left fielder. Ball's hit to short. Fielded cleanly. Throw on the first. It's back there. They pulled her off the bag, so she got on. E on the shortstop there. So one out. There was an out given to Williamsburg. And when they played the first inning, I don't think you want to do that.
Well, the Wildcats are definitely swinging. They are not waiting for anything.
Now, Jeffers.
Aggressive.
Jeffers is up. Two well on first. First pitch in there for a swinging strike. Foul back. No balls. Two strikes to Jeffers. Ninth batter in the order. Pitch is on its way. Foul back. A little change up there. Flint's trying to keep it down on him, that's for sure.
Looks like the Wildcats may want to run.
Well, you're up 3-0. You might as well take a chance. Get the runner started here. Two strikes. Who knows what could happen? Strike three, the batter.
That was low. Swung it well in the dirt, huh?
Oh, okay. It's going to work out like a delayed steal. But what happened there was the runner kind of messed the pitcher up. She was running to first, and you can't do that when first base is occupied. And a girl on first base, she thought she had to take off, so she took off. The pitcher threw it to first, and then the girl didn't make it to second. And the coaches are explaining, Wilmington's coaches out there telling you don't have to do that. And they're also telling the Williamsburg player you don't have to do that. So anyhow, we have two outs now and a runner at second.
At the plate for Williamsburg, number 20, Peyton Fisher.
And if you're coaching, on first base, third base, you got to let your players know that stuff, I'm sure they tell them that all the time, and we'll just forgot.
Got to remind them.
The coach should have just been yelling, stay. It ended up working out for them, because the pitcher will throw the ball to second. They've been two outs, and we've been, Wilmington could have been batting at that point. So here we go, back to the top of the order, and this is Fisher, and she had a base hit right up the gut the last time. Right up the middle.
That was a seeing eye hit there.
That was a nice hit. First pitch hit him, bam. Two outs, runner at second. Wilmington needs to try to get out of this inning without any damage being done. They've actually given Williamsburg two extra outs this inning. So, because we had the error on the bad throw from short, and then the girl running the second there, they should have had that as another out. So,
let's hope it doesn't result in any kind of a score.
Ball's in the dirt, but blocked nicely by Wilmington's catcher. Hunter Taylor. She does a nice job back there behind the plate. She don't let too many get by. Which is a swinging strike. One ball, one strike. Way up in the box is Fisher. Ball's hit the second, should be the third out, and it is. Ground out, second to first. So, no damage done that inning.
Up to bat this inning for Wilmington, number 1, Megan Fisher, number 4, Jatasia Johns, number 6, Jalen Hensley.
No hits, one error, and one left on base.
What's happening, man? Good to see you.
Good. So, been watching some of your stuff. You guys are doing a good job.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
And you're doing the Williamsburg game with us, too.
Yeah, yes, we'll do both.
We're going to do all three games.
Fixed you up.
All right. There you go.
All right. You got a roster. You got a lineup both for this game and the Wilmington game.
Wow.
And
Fairfield is organized and ready.
We always are.
That must be you. That's not Detweiler, is it?
You asked the young lady, her father is stationed above, and so is she noted on that so that we can make sure that we...
Third pitcher.
Your pitcher.
Yeah.
All right. Pitcher for the first game or second game or both games?
She'll probably start her both games.
Okay.
She won't
finish
game two, but she'll start game two.
Okay. Okay.
And you got stats, so...
We appreciate it. Wow. You're a man.
Yeah. Yeah. We're glad to help, so...
Yeah, that's neat. We never get stuff like that.
Don't talk about, but she has pitched 87 innings, and that's how many walks she has.
No walks. Wow.
Wow. 87 innings?
The ladies' board pitcher we're talking about, she's pitched 87 innings, and no walks. That's crazy.
Thanks.
Thanks.
I'll check with you.
Good to see you.
If any changes,
all right.
I don't think there will be.
All right.
We actually have a media packet from Leesburg. Thank you, Leesburg. That's nice.
Yeah. And you know, Williamsburg and us are rated in the top 10.
No, we didn't know that.
But first poll came out last week. We're number 7. They're number 8.
So. Williamsburg is number 8 in
that's four.
Division 4.
Right.
And Leesburg is number 7.
What league are you playing?
Southern Hills.
Yeah, that's what I said, yeah.
And we're both undefeated in each league, so.
Wow. So you guys only have 2 losses, don't you?
Yeah, they were second games of doubleheader. We pitched our
team. Oh, okay.
And dropped those games. They were still numbering games. East Clinton got us in Adina the very first day.
Well, it'll be an exciting second game.
We're looking forward to it.
Yeah. All right. Megan Fisher has 2 strikes on her now. Here comes the third fish. Nice pitch. We tied the ball. Tell you, maybe it's just me. I can't see. The Lions pitchers are looking pretty good in there, aren't they, for both teams?
They are. That was close. It was on the outside, but it was really close.
Strike 3. For Fisher. They're eighth ranked Williamsburg, it was found out, and Williamsburg is 7th ranked. In Division 4. Of course, Wilmington's D1, right?
I don't know whether the girls are D1. I would assume they are. They're obviously...
They may be D2.
They're D1 and D2. They're D2 as far as basketball, so I would assume that would be softball as well.
Yeah. First pitch to Jatasia Johns is a strike. She had a nice catch out in center earlier today.
And even in boys, we've only got 3 players over the limit to be in D2. We're in D1.
Yeah. Next pitch is a ball to Johns. 1 ball, 1 strike. Again, Wagers is still on the mound. This is going to be an exciting game, this second game, man.
Yeah, it will be. Well, actually, we could end up in D2 in all the sports next year, depending on the count of the boys. Number of boys that play the sports.
Next pitch is a strike to Johns. 1 ball, 2 strikes. 1 out here in the bottom of the second. So far, Wagers has struck out three of the first four that she's seen. Strike three for the first five.
That's some heat.
I tell you, when you see a pitcher like this, it reminds me of the old men's team years ago. I think I got to see him play one time. You ever hear the King and his court? The King and his court would come and play softball teams all around the country. It was a pitcher, a catcher, I think a first baseman, and a shortstop. I think that was all they played.
And they would be teams.
She backed up in the batter's box.
There you go.
Well, I hope so. We got Jalen Hensley up to bat. Because she likes to run forward, though.
Yeah,
that's why. Yeah,
she was a slapper, but she backed up in the box.
Strike on that pitch. I think we're at 0-2 or 1-1?
I think we're 1-1. Nope,
0-2. 0-2. No balls, two strikes.
Still 3-0. We're here in the second.
Strike three. Struck out the side, the Rangers. Hey! How are you doing, Miss Detweiler? This is Rick Phillips. We got Martin Detweiler here from the 7th ranked. Right? 7th ranked. So we're going to be climbing?
That's the goal.
I've been following you a little bit in the paper. I saw you only had like two losses, but then your assistant coach said that's just from the second end of double headers. So
double end or tail end of a double header, but
so, and that's all right because Wilmington High School boys, they do the same thing. They'll try to get some young people some action in that.
Riley, I'm sorry.
That makes sense.
We're looking forward to it.
This got me excited. We didn't want to play on doing the game anyhow, but we didn't realize both of you are ranked.
Nice.
And yeah, if you have a game down there you want us to do, this is the man to talk to, Rick Phillips. Because he was here in Wilmington.
Get your info here.
And you can go to the website. I got my, under the contact, I've got my cell phone number. You can just give me a call anytime. We'll get together. And
is there a big game that you want us to try to do or something? Let us know.
Okay.
You doing good?
I'm doing well.
Wife of the day, she a bookkeeper or anything?
She's in Indianapolis. She'll be.
What's she doing in Indianapolis?
She's out there at a trade show.
Oh, okay.
She'll be here in a little bit.
Oh, okay, cool.
Top of the third.
See, I like your wife. I like giving her a hard time. She gives it back, though.
Really?
Yeah. Good seeing you. Good seeing you. We'll razz you later. Clark coming up, first time up. She hit a base hit. And change up to her. She drills it to left center. That one's going to drop. It's going to go almost to the wall. Having a hard time picking it up in the outfield, but she's going to hang in there second.
Right.
So Clark is 2-for-2, and Jatania Johns almost got to that ball. She was only about...
He was tailing away from her.
It was only about maybe 2 feet from her. She had good hustle over to try to get it, but just couldn't make it. Smith coming up. She got on via the base on balls the first time. She scores the bunt, but then lines it past the shortstop for base hit. They're going to hold the runner at third. So the runners are first and third. I tell you, that was drilled.
We've had more people in our press box here, Charlie, than we've ever.
Leesburg guys, they got your press pack, too. That's the best part.
That was really nice, yeah.
Wagers coming up. First time up, she grounded out to the first baseman. Nobody out. Runners at first and third. First pitch is a ball. The 8th-ranked Williamsburg Wildcats in Division 4, they're leading Wilmington right now, 3-0.
I think the only other teams that ever done that, Mulder's basketball team, they brought us a press pack, pretty impressive.
So there's first and third, nobody out. Wilmington's in a bind here. Williamsburg's coming to do their business this inning. Bunt laid down. They're going to hold the runner at third, throw to first, and she's safe. She beats it out.
Bases are loaded.
So we got the bases loaded, and guess who's coming up? Babe Ruth herself, Gullett. She hit the first one out of the park to left center.
Yeah.
So you know what she's thinking right now. She's saying, give me that salami up here so I can knock it back out of the park and get two of them today, get two dingers. Yeah, she hit it clear over the left center field wall.
Now this one would be a grand slam. So
that's what I mean, yeah.
You went the salami, right?
That's what I said, the grand salami, baby. You caught on to that. I'm glad of it.
Yeah.
A lot of people probably missed that. I'm glad you explained that to everybody. But at the plate, Flint pitching, bases loaded, Wilmington needs to get an out of some kind here. Ooh, called a strike.
All the runners are in motion.
Yep, one ball, one strike, nobody out. So you softball aficionados and baseball aficionados know that the infield fly rule is in effect. That drill to left, and that's going to go clear the wall. One runs in, two runs in. They're going to send the third run, and she's going to score as well. We have a base-clearing double by Gullett.
Nice hit.
Oh, just drilled it. Same spot, left center, just hit it on a line this time.
Number 19, Taylor Kirshner.
Kirshner coming up. And that doubles our lead 6-0 for Williamsburg.
Well, we know why they're ranked.
Oh, my. Good ball team. Real good ball team. So we have a runner at second. We have a courtesy runner that went out there. I'm not sure who that was. I didn't catch the number. And that's it. The left center again. And it's going to drop right in front of Jatasia Johns. So we're going to hold the runner at third. Ball does get away from the shortstop on the throw in, but she's still held up. So we have the courtesy runner at third and Kirshner with a base hit.
Williamsburg.
Last time she threw out the left field, Ogden did. And again, no outs here for the Williamsburg Wildcats with three runs in and runners at first and third. Fouled off, first pitch. Again, you guys, if you're listening the first time, we have a sister network called TalkTV.us. There's some shows on there already. You can go back and watch. If you like old cars or car shows, check out Keep Calm and Chaz On. If you like the political scene, check out The Razor's Edge, and that's on TalkTV.us.
All right, we've got the NFL mock draft starting, being from 1 to 4 tomorrow on the Sports Planet on TalkTV.us.
TalkTV.us. Ball's hit. Third baseman, she's going to go to first with it. They get the out there. Runner holds at third, but the other runner does advance to second. So we have an out, and Tidwell coming to the plate for Wilmington, for Williamsburg, the left fielder. Wow. Last time she hit the ball at shortstop and got on via the air. One out. Ball's popped up to the left side. I don't know if it's going to be in play or not to catch.
Just missed.
Foul ball.
Just out of reach.
But there's also another sports show on there. You just did the first episode last week. What's it called?
Oh, that's the Sports Planet. Sports Planet. We were at Ohio State for the spring game, and we didn't do the spring game, but we did a tailgate party and talked to Ohio State sports. And then tomorrow is this NFL mock draft. We do more national as well as local sports. Campus Nation, obviously, high school and college sports, D3 college.
One ball, one strike. Really like for some five more people to watch my first edition of Keep Calm and Chaz On. That put us at 300 viewers.
There you go.
Swinging strike there on the changeup by Tidwell. One ball, two strikes, one out. Runners at second and third for Williamsburg.
What you don't know, Charlie, it may already have those 5 years.
I don't know. Ball up. Two balls, two strikes. Said, well, it's a good-looking team. I mean, that pitcher for Williamsburg, she's got some heat. Ball's hit up in the air. And it drops for a base hit. And runner second has to hold because she couldn't tell whether it was going to be called or not.
Right.
And runner for third comes in. It's 7-0.
Number 27, Emma Jeffries.
And we do have the run rule.
Ten run rule. Jeffers coming up. And she K'd the first time up bat Well, runners at first and second with one out. Then Jeffers is at the plate. Ball's hit hard through the gap. Pretty short and third. They will hold the runners up. Base is loaded.
Now the Wildcats just keep pouring it on.
Yep, and that was the ninth batter in the order, so here we go, back up to the top. Number 20, Fisher, we have a visit to the mound now. Looks like maybe we're going to make a change or not. Yep, looks like we're going to make a change.
Well, the way they're hitting, it would be hard to believe it's going to make much of a difference, right?
They're just drilling the ball. I'll tell you what. 90% of their hits have been to the left center field gap, shortstop is there. So I'd be shading that low on every batter, because that's just where they're hitting it to. Just so you know, Rick, in case you ever look at these, wanting to know, that's what these little lines up here mean. That's where they actually
hit the ball.
I'm just explaining in case you ever wonder what the heck you do that for. There you know. We have runners at first, second, and third. Bases full. And Fisher coming up. And Fisher has got on by base hit in the first inning and grounded out second. So she's one for two. New pitcher in for the Hurricane is
Courtney Smart.
And, of course, we're coming to you live from the campus of Wilmington High School. CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports.
Courtney Smart, pitching for the Hurricane, coming in here in the top of the third. This could get ugly, folks. Like I said, Williamsburg is 8th ranked, and Leesburg is 7th ranked. And Leesburg, the only two losses come on back ends of doubleheaders. One to East Clinton and one to Edina, just because they were trying to throw some young pitchers and just get some more players in also. So, and a lot of the teams do that, which is cool. Or they possibly could be undefeated at this point. Not sure what Williamsburg record is. We'll have to find that out after the game.
I thought that they were Williamsburg's actual record in the season. Are you talking about the Lions?
The Lions
are undefeated, aren't they?
No, the Fairfield Lions have lost two games.
All right.
But they're undefeated in their league, and Williamsburg's undefeated in the league, too. First two pitches into Carter are balls.
And both in D4.
Yes. That's hit hard. Caught by the third baseman. Nice catch here.
It's almost trying to double it up, huh?
Who is that playing third down there for the Hurricane?
Should be
Megan Fisher? Megan Fisher, nice play. Next pitch is hit up in the air to right field. And it's a fly out, so the Hurricane escaped those runners scoring. Clark, his first pitch hitting. So they leave three on base. Hurricane that inning really didn't have any errors, but Williamsburg got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hits in that inning. 5 hits, no errors, 3 left on base.
Will be number 23.
4 runs in.
Number 5, Kelsey Bayer, and number 7, Cherokee McClaskey.
Coming up for Wilmington, they haven't even got around the batting order yet. They're getting ready to do that right now. They have 7, 8, and 9 coming up. Seth, Bayer, and McClaskey. And the girl for Williamsburg, Wagers, has had 5 strikeouts out of the 6 batters she's faced, and obviously has no hitter going right now at this point. And Kelsey, Lila Self, Kelsey Bayer, and Cherokee McClaskey.
You're up to 196 on your first show, Charlie, so you just need 4.
Did you just hit it?
No, I didn't hit it. I'm just looking at it.
That's my other one's hit numbers right there.
Oh, just curious. Right there now.
I think we got over 100 for the first Thursday show.
Yeah, you do. Thursday show, you're at 155.
That's not bad.
And you're at 268 on the show before that. And then, of course, 296 on the first show. So, yeah.
I'm excited about next week's show already. I've got John Girard coming in from AutoZone. And I've got a Jim Green. Jim Green's one of these dudes that goes all around the country and works for the National Street Rod Association doing safety inspections.
Oh, wow.
So that's going to be a lot of fun to have those two on there. First pitch is a ball itself. It must have been outside, you reckon? That looks like it's pretty good, level-wise.
So we're here at the bottom of the third inning. Wilmington down 7-0 in this first game of a triple header.
Second at bat. That's what you call a rise ball. That thing kept rising and rising and rising.
Yeah. Number 23 would have had to have been twice as tall as she was in order to even reach up and get it.
You know, the sad thing about that, though, where that leaves a pitcher's hand at is so low.
And you can't tell where it's actually going.
Blazers is laughing about it out there, too. She's like, oops, let that one go away. Three balls, and she might lose her here. She needs to come back strong. The first pitch, it was thrown in there. It probably could have been called a strike, but it wasn't. Somebody got her off a little bit. Three balls, no strikes. These high school kids, I tell you what, it doesn't take much. They can get off real quick. Four straight pitches. And that's kind of what I said in the first inning Wilmington needs to do.
A little loss of control there.
Well, I tell you, Wilmington gave her probably three or four swinging strikes the first inning. It would have been called balls.
Okay. Got to be more patient.
So Lila Self on first base and Kelsey Bear coming to the plate. Left-hander against left-hander here. Bottom of the third. She squares the bat and pops it up out of play.
So do we think she was actually really trying to sacrifice or bunt to get on?
Oh, I think she was trying to sacrifice. Trying to get that runner in scoring position, make something positive happen.
Good bunt.
Nice run. She might make it to first on this. That was picked up by the shortstop, and they throw her out. That was a nice little bunt.
That was perfect.
So they have sacrifice by Kelsey Bear. So that moves Lila Self over to second base with one out. Cherokee McClaskey coming up. And the pitch. Pitch is high to McClaskey, ball one. Pitch was on play. Inside. Two balls. Yeah, I tell you, Wagers has kind of lost her momentum a little bit this inning. I mean, she's still not in any trouble. She still hasn't given up a hit yet. She just gave up the base on balls, and she's down 2-0 here to Cherokee McClaskey. Cherokee swinging strike there. Two balls, one strike. Big lead down there by Lila Self. Second baseman got over that time. Just wonder if the catcher might wing one down there.
She's showing two strikes, one ball.
I had two balls, one strike, so I... Oh, my fault. I guess I was wrong. Another strikeout there to McClaskey. Two outs.
So we actually witnessed the first time you were wrong, Charlie.
I'm wrong a lot. I'll be the first to admit it. But again, it's hard for us to hear in here, too, because I'm very
happy. Open the window.
No, I'm very happy. I was going to say I'm very happy we are in here, but, you know, it's... We don't hear any audible strike or ball call. We just kind of have to watch him. Swinging strike there. I might have been tipped.
Really, if you look at the flag out there, the flag's not moving much.
Because there's no flag there. There's a flag way over there.
I can see it. I can see it, Charlie.
It's moving pretty good. Let's call over to the school.
I know. I got these razor-sharp eyes. I saw that.
Strike three. To Hunter Toller. That's twice she struck out today. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 strikeouts Wagers has through three innings. And still no hits yet.
No, we got a no-hitter going on here.
And we had one left on base that inning via the walk. So, top of the fourth, and we got Smith, Wagers, and Gullick coming up. And I tell you what, Smith is 1-for-1, Wagers is 1-for-2.
So, Smith, number 8.
And
number 62.
Gullick's 2-for-2. She's one hit a home run and a double.
16.
And our second game coming up in this triple header, we've got Leesburg Fairfield. Against
number 7,
Leesburg against number 8, that's right, so that'll be a good matchup there, that'll be exciting.
Nice having two state-ranked teams
both
here.
In D4, so, it'll be an exciting game that we'll have this second game.
Looks like we're making some changes on the Wilmington side of things. We'll bring in to you when they come up to bat. Looks like we got a new catcher, that maybe number 1 catching. Who's that?
Megan Fisher
going in to catch.
She's the backup catcher. And you have Brooklyn Keaton, number 11 at third.
Probably doing some of this because of this third game that the Wilmington will be playing. Yeah.
And you have in right field, you have number 3, Lillian Hebb.
Out there in right field.
You have number 9, Macy Fulton.
Macy Fulton in left field. Fulton or Bolton?
Fulton.
All right.
And you also have number 19, Leia Bradshaw, went in at second base.
Leia Bradshaw, second. So full house changes. We'll get those to you when they come up to the bat, because we'll have to make the changes in. But,
right, want to make sure everybody gets their name on the broadcast.
Right.
We know who they are when they're out there.
Right.
Wildcats coming up for their next at-bat in the top of the fourth inning, leading 7-0.
7-0, yes, with Williamsburg on top. If you're listening out there today, give us a shout out, text me or Facebook message me, let me know what's happening, all right?
Well, we have to have your number, Trevor.
Most people are listening, I'm sure they have my number.
Well, we probably have a lot of new listeners now.
That's true, 937, that's true, I forgot about the Williamsburg people. 937-218-2290.
Okay, let us know, we'll pass it along, give a shout out.
Yep. Ball's hit, the short, throw on the first, and she's out.
And just a reminder, this video that we're taping, because obviously right now we're just doing live audio, video will be available in the order that the games are played. So the first video for this game will be available sometime probably around 1 o'clock, and then we'll have the second video and the third video, and the third video will probably be late tomorrow night. So that would be the nightcap with Leesburg and Wilmington.
Ball fouled off by Rangers, left side. Out of play?
Yep.
So we are in the top of the fourth right now. 7-0 Williamsburg. There is a 10-run rule. If Williamsburg would happen to get up 10 runs and hold the cane, then...
And that would be after 5 innings,
that
right?
That would be after 5.
And Wilmington would still get their at-bat.
Yes. And if Wilmington would cut it to 9, you go on and play the 6.
That's right. And so on and so on.
Because I tell you what, I've seen it. I tell you, you can come back from 9 or 10 runs, to be honest with you.
Well, it's softball. Anything can happen.
2-1 to Wagers. She has a base hit and ground out to the first baseman the first time up. Another strike. Swinging strike. That was almost an excuse me swing. It's like, oh, they're not. And it was too late by the time she got stopped with her swing. 2-2. Ball's drilled to center. Stacey Jones fields it cleanly and throws the ball back in. Base hit. It's her second hit on the day, Rangers. Gullick now. Gullick's 2-for-2 with 4 ribbies today. She had a 3-run double last time up. The first time up, she jacked one over the left field fence. First pitch is a strike to Gullick. So you got to treat her carefully. If you won't give her anything real good to it. Ball's up high. One ball, one strike. Wager's getting a nice lead down there at first. Kyle Hake getting the catcher to say, hey, come on, throw that ball down here. Fouled back. Back go it. Stopped by the catcher. The runner takes off. Kind of bobbled her a little bit, and she makes it to second.
Once again, aggressive on the base pads.
Two balls, two strikes. Runner in scoring position for the ribeye steak, love and garlic. She's got a bunch of ribeyes today.
That sounds good. I'm hungry.
I could hit her. Well, take her base.
In fact, I thought about that. We were down in Hillsboro yesterday and went past the Ponderosa down there. And that would be a good place to eat.
Yeah, we'll take us there one night.
Yeah, sure.
One ball, two strikes.
Number 19.
Got a man at the mound here.
If we do any spring sports in Hillsboro, I'll take you there.
I have to call Hillsboro softball coach. Say, hey, we got a good game going on. Hey, we can do pretty close to Hillsboro. That's only about 8 or 9 miles down the road.
Yeah, you've got some pull there, so you probably would get him to set it up.
You know I am with free food, baby.
I know. Oh, it's not free. It's free for you.
Hey, it is.
Yeah.
For me, it would be.
Uh-huh.
But see, you're getting all this free labor. I feel like a...
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Compensation?
I feel like, what is...
Besides,
all those women in the factory sewing dresses in the 1950s or 60s.
You enjoy telling everybody that you work for food.
That's right. I like to work for a little bit better food, though. I like McDonald's, but at least step up the Burger King, the size of four.
Well, I mean, today it's just you and me. We might just go someplace special, Charlie, especially since we're doing three softball games.
Well, we're probably going to eat in between games.
I don't know. I have no idea.
Pitch is on its way.
Thought somebody was knocking.
I hear you knocking.
Okay.
Runner at first and second. Rick tries singing. It's getting scary, folks. You might want to sit down. You're getting lightheaded. Next pitch drilled right up the middle. The pitcher almost had it. Runner's coming around. Was going to come to score, but she held up at third, so we have the bases loaded again. Kushner drilled that one right up the middle.
Number 7, Megan Ogden.
Ogden coming to the bat. Runs the first, second, and third. One out. Ogden 0 for 2 on the day. She flew out to left and then grounded out to third. One out. Base is loaded. Ball's hit in the air. That's going to drop. It's going to be a base hit. They throw the ball past the third baseman. The runner at third's going to hold, though. So I'll go down. This is a base hit. 8-0. Ball did get away, but didn't hurt anything.
A lot of action there, but just one run scored.
And you know what, if that's 2 or 3 feet shorter, they're probably going to call infield fly rule on that. Tidwell up. Tidwell has got on via the air and also a base hit today. She won for 2. Bases are still loaded. 1 out, 8-0 there now, which is significant because if they do get to 10, you know, Wilmington's got to score.
Well, but we're still in the fourth, so it's one more inning.
Right, yeah, you got to get to the fifth. But, I mean, the way Williamsburg's pitcher is cruising along, I don't see much problem.
I know, she's pretty tough.
2 balls here.
All the runners are moving. They're ready to score.
Tidwell, it's 2 balls, no strikes to Tidwell. Again, we have Smart now pitching. She come in relief for Flint last inning. That was a ball? Okay. three other boys might as well can pitch here. Must have been outside. And the pitch is on its way. Strike one. Taking all the way was Tidwell, which I don't blame him.
No, I would have.
I used to teach my girls, take a strike, make the pitcher work a little bit. Ball four, walks the next run in. Hate to see that happen. So all the runners move up, and it's 9-0. And coming up to the plate is Jeffers, who has singled and struck out.
Now she looks tall.
Yeah, she's a nice batter in the order, too. Fouled back. First pitch, swinging.
It's quite possible some of these girls may be right off the basketball team.
I bet a lot of them do, because, yeah, it's a smaller school, so the girls...
They have to participate in multiple sports.
You see a lot, you know,
field teams.
Two, three sport players. Ball's hit. Caught by the third baseman.
Trying to throw back to first.
Yep. And they didn't call it in for a foul because it was on the line, you know. So you couldn't even think about calling it that quick. So we have two outs now.
Peyton Fisher.
9-0, and the leadoff batter's coming up, and she is 1-for-3 on the day. She has hit a rocket base hit up the gut. Flew out and grounded out. So base is loaded, 9-0. Next pitch. Ball's hit, should be caught by the first baseman, and it is.
All right.
So, three outs, and Wilmington will come to bat here, still without a hit in the bottom of the fourth, and they'll have their second, third, and fourth batters coming up. They had a bunch of changes, so Hannah Chase, Courtney Smart, Megan Fisher is who the starters would have been, but we will see when they come up, because
right.
I think
they've all been substituted.
A lot of them have had substitutes. But
simply because we're playing a doubleheader, at least each team is playing two games, and so they've got to keep their team fresh. That's why we've got all these backups for us, Charlie. We got people coming in for us.
Yeah,
where
I think we're it. That's for us today. That's all right. You know, we got it easy in here.
That's right.
I'm hoping it's warmed up. I would like to try to call a game outside just so I can see them third base line. I may try that next game.
We don't have a workers' compensation, so...
That's right. We got a fence there. You don't have to be responsible for that.
You got Obamacare?
I've got my own health care, okay. So Medical Mutual. I'll tell you what, if you're shopping around, Medical Mutual is a good company to go through. And they wouldn't pay me for anything for that. They should.
But they should pay me.
Well, and then you can give me a cut. That's fine.
I'd give you an extra cheeseburger.
Number 13, Hannah Chase.
Killing me. All right, here we go. You probably all start feeding me healthier if you want me to stick around. There you go. Hannah Chase, and you know the worst thing.
Are you talking about your wife, or are you talking about...
Worst thing about American food right now, if it's healthy, it costs twice as much. First pitch in to Chase is at the better pitcher. She throws on the first. First pitch out, swinging out. Courtney Smart coming to the plate.
Wilmington, number 2, Courtney Smart.
I could take you to Whole Foods, and you could just walk around and eat food off the shelf.
No.
How's that?
No.
No?
No. No.
All that organic stuff?
No. Some of that's probably all right.
Probably like eating cardboard.
First pitch in there for a ball. Courtney Smart. Tell you what, this Wager, she's still firing. I don't know what she would be on the gun, but I tell you what, it's got to be what, 50, 60 at least? Foul back.
So, now I wonder who will be pitching game two.
Well, you know what? Fairfield said they're going to start the same rule for Williamsburg and Wilmington.
But are there pitch counts in high school?
No. And softball, yeah, you don't have the stress on your arm throwing underneath.
So there's no pitch counts.
Yeah, and especially if they only do 5 innings, you know, she's got some innings.
Well, that's true. If they could tack on another run and keep continuing to shut Wilmington out, yeah. They'll hit Wilmington and...
2 balls, 1 strike here to Smart in the bottom of the fourth, 9-0.
Yeah, and I haven't had to move the camera much for Wilmington, huh?
Oh, ball's at the third.
Uh-oh.
Might get it out. It's kind of...
Still an out.
Still an out. Kind of bobbled there by the third baseman, but she ended up fielding it, throwing the ball. The first get the out.
So, no hitter intact.
Yeah, well, even if she'd have got on, you'd have
been an error.
Yeah.
Right.
So, two outs, and coming up is Meg Fisher.
Has there been a walk?
One walk.
Okay.
One walk, and that was the live itself last inning. No strikeout this inning, though. Strike one to Megan Fisher. Wagers has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 K's on the day and has had a K, at least one K in each inning. Ball, the changeup there. It shouldn't have been too many of those. Ball's pulled way foul because she's waiting on that fastball to come out there. No balls, two strikes. Wilmer can tie the left fielder softball-wise.
They have been struggling, that's for sure.
A couple games they probably could have won, but they
let them get away.
They've won a few games, though.
Yes, they have.
Foul back into the catcher's mitt for strike three. There's that strikeout. So, here we go. We're going into the top of the fifth, 9-0, and Williamsburg has the meat of the order coming up. Clark, who is 2-for-3. Smith, who is 1-for-2 with a walk. And then Wagers, who is 2-for-3. And Gullett, who is 2-for-2 with a hit by pitch.
Back this inning for Williamsburg, number 23, Riley Clark. Number 8, Casey Smith. Number 62, Carmen Wagers.
Yep, so it's Clark, Smith, Wagers coming up. Looks like Williamsburg coach is making a change. I think they only have 10 players on their club because I think that's their reserve and varsity. I think they only brought 10 with them today. Because on his lineup card, he only had one extra.
Number two has substituted in and will be at bat.
You're listening to high school softball on CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports. A triple header today, live from Wilmington High School. We want to thank everybody for tuning in and invite you to listen to each of our games today.
Now, can you tell how many are listening right now? Just curious.
No.
I mean, I could, but I have to go
through a lot in order to do that. We can see live stats as far as going to our content delivery network as to how many people are on the audio.
That's one thing that's kind of interesting about that Facebook Live. It tells you how many is listening, going on and off and all that.
Yeah, right.
And tells people to, you know, people can comment on there. So, here we go. First pitch, foul back. We have Roan in the game right now for Williamsburg. Number two, she's subbing in for Clark. Ball's hit up in the air, left side.
Caught.
Okay, first out. Shortstop catch that?
Yes.
Okay. Again, we're blind on that side. Fly out to shortstop. We have Smith coming up, who is, like I said, 1-for-2 on the day with a walk. Williamsburg, I would think, would be wanting to get that run in just because it's going to be a long day.
I would say so, yeah. They'd like to tack on that extra run and hold the cane to, you know, no score and worry about game number three.
They'll be playing in two.
Yeah, they get to go home.
Yep, they get to go home. Right.
Maybe I can get them to go out and get me a coffee at Tim Hortons to come back.
I don't know. I wonder if they are feeding anybody in 20 games. Maybe they're not really feeding anybody. We don't need to go in that, though.
Do we think they are?
Wilmington is feeding the other team.
Oh, yes. Okay, good.
Well, we usually slide in that. Yeah, we are the other team.
We're the home team.
Two balls, one strike.
The baseball team feeds us, right?
Yes, the baseball team does.
Football team has to feed us. That's like a given.
It sounds like you want as high as I am.
No, I have to.
Wow, called strike, and the batter had to back up. She's not very happy. Two balls, two strikes to Smith. Coach is fouled off.
I'm on that extreme regimen getting ready for working it.
Yeah, you can't eat anything.
I have to be real careful.
Or you need to eat a lot so your stats look better before you start. Balls hit down third baseline, but foul. Hit hard there by Smith. Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, probably just watching you eat would give me 300 calories, Shirley.
I tell you, that's where I am. I hate these people who walk around, they're like a buck 20, and they eat everything in sight. I look at the food, and I gain weight.
Yeah.
Yep, that's the problem. Uh-oh, ball hit the right center. That's going to go to the wall. She's going to get at least a second. I would say they're going to send her to third. They are. She's on her way to third. Ball's thrown in there. No play on her. Triple.
Another nice knock, and they are in scoring position. Yep.
Triple by Smith. Hit it right out the right center. And that's probably going to let Gullett come to the plate here. This is Wagers up right now. Wagers had a nice day, though, too. She is 2-for-3 with a ground out. So on third, Wagers up. And the pitch is on its way, and it's low for a ball.
Your idea of a personal trainer would be somebody that feeds you.
Feeds you right. That'd be all right.
Well, Wendy's working up my diet.
Okay, yeah, I just make a copy of that stuff for me. One ball, one strike.
Right. Like you look at it and say, okay. No.
Who's been on my fitness pal? Thank you very much. Ball's hit to right field. And it's Smith. Runs will score. Runners on the way to third. Battle is. She'll have fun to the plate.
Home.
And home run. You give her a home run, you give her the error.
I think that would have to be an error.
Yeah, it probably would be. But I don't know. Did she actually touch it out there?
Yeah, it was in her glove and she was the one that came out.
Okay. All right. You couldn't see that, Jeremy? Well,
I think I was blocked out. You were thinking of food. You were distracted.
That's right. So, that gives the Williamsburg Wildcats a little insurance run here, too.
That's right. They've got 11 runs now.
So, Wagers 11. It's 11 to nothing now. She drilled that ball right field. Thought the right fielder was going to catch it, which that still would be enough to get the 10th run in. But she just misjudged it. And that's far away, and that ball was hit so high, by the time she got to it, heck, Wagers was already around first, and she just took off and came all the way home. Ball's drilled past the third baseman by Gullett. That ball was hit hard.
It was.
3-for-3 for the day with a walk. She's been on every time, and she scored every time. Kirshner now up.
19, Michaela Kirshner.
19, Kirshner at the plate. Ball's low in the dirt. So we do have one out here in the top of the fifth. Williamsburg on top, 11-0. Pitch called a strike. One ball, one strike. Ball's hit hard to center. Almost had a play there at second. If Jones would have thrown the ball, didn't she faster. She didn't throw the ball. She kind of held up. So there's a base hit right up the gut by Kirshner. She is 3-for-4 today. She's having a good day. Now we have Ogden coming up. Ogden is, I don't know what she did last time. Not real sure.
Don't you think she's 0-2?
Yeah, I do, but I think she must have walked last time. 0-for-2, because you're right, I don't have the line. But when you're keeping the book, there's a lot to write, especially when you're talking at the same time and thinking of it.
Well, that's true. It's hard for you to do two things at once.
That's right. Strike the batter. We have one ball, one strike on Ogden. There's a first and second.
And you teach young minds.
One out for one more year. One more year. Maybe two. We'll see.
There you go. Extending it, huh?
Well, so much of it's not in my control. You know, I got to know what the wife's going to be doing. I need to know what my daughter wants to do.
Could be making six figures.
Yeah, we'll see. I hope. Ball's hit up in the air. I think it's going to be foul. Got it? Did we get it?
No.
Yep. I guess it's the foul ball.
Foul ball.
Spider's coming back. See, that's Rick's razor eye.
That was beyond, that was even beyond the,
I had my x-ray vision to be able to see that.
Like I said, I may try outside the next game.
I mean, look, Charlie, I'm doing the camera, I'm talking. I mean, you're talking about only being able to do one thing at a time.
All you're thinking about is Litany. Yeah. One ball, two strikes. Working it with Litany, a new show on TalkTV.us. Watch Rick Phillips go from the mighty man he is of 200, how many bones?
230, I think.
240, 250,
230.
Yeah.
Actually,
one, 195.
I had to start my, your
ball is by the catcher.
So I waited last night.
On the way. They go to third and second. Two balls, two strikes. Sorry, you guys listening at home, whatever it is, just we like to have fun. And we basically all volunteers for the most part, at least I am. So,
yeah, and I'm making a million off this.
Runners at second and third. One out. Ball's hit hard, left side, but it was foul, though.
Although, just for everybody out there, we are looking at opening some studios right here in Wilmington, Ohio. And looked at space yesterday. Looks like very promising, and we'll be able to actually have
people
be in studio and do stuff.
We do have advertisers too, especially during basketball and football. But
right, well, we're going big time here. Once we get the studios in line and everything else, everything's a work in progress. Let's put it that way.
The nice thing about advertising out here on Talk TV or CampusNation.com is, you know, people can go back and see the videos
over and over again, right?
And for the state tournament game, we had over 2,000 listening live.
2,047, I think. And then we've had...
That's hit the slope, but it goes by. One run's going to score. They got third. She's safe. Ball goes by. She's not coming to the plate, though, and the runner goes to second.
I think we've had close to 900 views of the Centerville playoff game with Wilmington. That was at the CentOS Center at Xavier.
Yep.
That is our highest scoring of the tournament games, but I think we've had close to 600, or maybe a little over 600 in the Final Four game that we did.
Tidwell at the plate. She fouls the first one back. We have runners at second and third now.
And of course, it was that Final Four game that we had the 2,047 live listeners.
Still only one out. And Tidwell at the plate. Williamsburg has her 12 runs. Has to Wilmington zero. No balls, two strikes. And there's a 10-run rule, so yeah, this game might get started.
Stopped.
Well, the second game might get started a little earlier, so if you're in the Leesburg area, you know, hopefully you're tuned in already. And I assume there'll probably be about a 20-minute, half-hour gap between games.
Yeah, I would imagine there's at least 20 minutes.
Ball. One ball, two strikes.
Especially when it comes to eating, Charlie, you eat pretty fast.
What's that got to do with a break between games?
Well, they're going to wait till you're done eating.
No, they aren't. Ball's hit in the left field. Base hit. One runs in. And runner moves over to third. Well, we need to get some outs. So it's going to get real ugly because we're toward the bottom end of the order now.
Right now it's
order over.
Yeah. With it being 13-0, we still have one out and two base runners.
Runners first throw looks like we may be making a pitching change.
We're going to see this probably end after five innings regardless.
Yes.
No matter how ugly it gets this inning, or this half of the inning.
Look, Williamsburg will save some of them hits. Got the Fairfield Lions.
That's not going to be an easy game this
year. One step ahead of you. That game may go quick because that could be like a 1-0, 2-0 affair,
I'm thinking.
Or a 2-1 affair, something along the lines of that. Because that's, I think we have two really good pitchers going at it. I'm kind of excited to watch that game and call that game.
Yeah, let's see if I can.
Number 5, Kelsey
Bear. Kelsey Bear is going to come in, be our next pitcher for Wilmington. This will be their third pitcher of the day.
And
Like I said, it's 13-0 right now.
Right. Our next Campus Nation broadcast will be the 25th, which would be this Monday, I guess. The Washington Blue Lions will be in to face the Hurricane in high school baseball. And that game now, will get underway at 4:45.
Have you talked to your son, Annie? Is he going to come down to any of these games?
You mean as far as video?
AJ.
Oh, AJ. Is that my son?
Yeah.
My prodigy. He's not my son. I don't know. AJ will find out today. Well, actually, you found out yesterday.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought you'd know.
What day he's on. I'll have to text him and ask him. Yeah. He likes doing baseball.
You got baseball Monday.
He knows nothing about lacrosse, so he probably won't endeavor to do that. And your wife likes lacrosse, so you know.
Yeah. I just want to know. I need to kind of get my week sorted out.
Yeah, because you have such a busy... You are a busy man.
Yeah,
right?
I am.
Yeah.
And, especially I like to give a little girl lady an open swim or two if possible, but if not, you know, it'll work out one way or the other. First pitch by Kelsey Baird to Jeffers is a ball outside. One out. Runners at first and third. Ball's hit right back to Bear. She holds her at third to get the out at first.
So we have two outs,
and coming to the plate is Fisher, the leadoff hitter.
Number 20, Peyton Fisher.
Who's 1-for-4 today. Probably not her normal day, I would say. Only just kind of held her in check. She had a nice base hit to lead off the game. First pitch, ball. Now, the catcher caught that way, it would be a strike, but it has so much of an arc on it that she called it a ball.
Foul.
Ball's fouled.
Oh. He made a change at third base.
That's
he
okay.
Hunter Toller back in.
Hunter Toller now playing third. One ball, one strike. Ball's hit to second base, and that ends the inning. So, going into the bottom of the fifth, it is 13-0.
Still a no-hitter.
Still a no-hitter going. Not a perfect game. She did have a walk to Lila Self. Lila Self would be the third batter this inning. We have Jatasia, depending on the changes, folks, we have Jatasia Johns, Jalen Hensley, and Lila Self should be coming to the plate. And it is 13-0, and Wagers is still rocking and rolling out there.
She is rocking, yeah. Impressive team. Although Wilmington has struggled this season,
Wilmington is not a bad team. But I tell you what, it don't really matter how your team is. It just comes down to this pitcher. You got a good pitcher, you can go a long way in softball. Bruce sends the ball down, and we're getting ready to start the bottom of the fifth.
For Wilmington, number 4, Jatasia Johns.
13-0.
See if we can get a hit. At least break up this no-hitter.
No, Red's got no hit the other night.
Yeah, we don't want to talk about them.
I'm just saying they got no hit. Everybody knows it's going to be a rebuilding year for Reds.
It's been a rebuilding century for the Reds, it seems like.
It does seem like that. Johns at the plate. First pitch is a ball. And Wagers is kind of wondering where that one was at because it looked pretty good. That's probably a little low. It was low, but it was a good heat. Swinging strike by Jatasia Johns.
Although my son is going, I think, to the Reds game tomorrow. He had 4 pretty good tickets down the third baseline.
That's still an event. It's still something to do.
Yeah, I've been to the new stadium. If it's new now, once.
Because
they said they were going to put some good product on the field. And
how did you know? I know. You went because you were free.
That's what I'm saying. I hadn't gone because I said I wasn't going until they had some decent talent out there. And even when I went, I only went, just to please you.
Two balls, two strikes. I tell you where we went that was kind of fun and interesting was that other game.
In Mason.
Yeah, what was the name of that place?
I forget the name of it. It's a pharmaceutical company that actually puts this on, but it's
like free New Johns.
It's really nice. It's everything's free. They give you
free food,
which is you, Charlie. That's
free ball games.
Right. They pass out stuff for the
Cincinnati.
Kids.
Cincinnati. What's the name of that?
It's in Mason.
Yeah, but they call them the Cincinnati something. I tell you what.
It's college kids.
It's interesting. Number three at the plate. Now, who's this?
Lillian Hebb.
Lillian Hebb coming to the plate.
Let's see if Miss Hebb can get us a hit here.
First pitch is a strike. Swinging strike to Lillian Hebb. Another swinging strike. Eight balls, two strikes. Wagers has had 9 strikeouts today. Fouled off.
I would still say she's not quite as impressive as the Massey.
I think she's just as good.
She has a faster ball, but I think that as far as location and all that.
I'd say she's better. If we were drafting, I'd take this girl first. Strike three.
She's taller.
Called strike.
The head girl, I think, got real lost on the count there.
Yeah. 19,
2 outs.
Harriet Bradshaw
coming up now to hit.
Her two came outs. Down to the last out, it would appear, if it's 13 to nothing and the score holds up. Obviously, this is a run rule.
First pitch is a ball. I tell you, when Wagers misses on these low pitches, she don't miss by much. And again, no hitter intact. So this, we got no hitter, and next pitch is a swinging strike by Bradshaw. One ball, one strike to Bradshaw. Next pitch took a little off. That one will change up. One ball, two strikes. So, Wilmington is down to her last strike right here, and Wagers is down to her last strike for a no-hitter.
It's a ball.
Umpire's making her earn it. The two balls he's called this batter, I mean, they've both been close.
Another ball.
Yeah, Wagers can't believe it. She's out there on the mound. You can just tell by her reaction. Like, how do you call out a ball? Yeah, which I'm kind of on her side a little bit on that. Full count.
You've got a different angle, Charlie.
Yeah.
Another
wow,
ball.
He walked her.
Second walk.
Kelsey.
Number 11, Brooklyn Keaton.
Brooke Keaton coming up.
Getting some instructions from the coach. Well, he's talking to the ump.
Yeah, well, we got to change. So should have been Kelsey Bird, and says Brooklyn Keaton coming up. I got both this little girl's parents in school at East Clinton.
Yeah, it says how old you are.
I know I'm old. You know what I tell me. Everybody tells me every day. I had a guest on my talk show the other night. I never met before on Facebook. Hey, you want to know when they're taking me back to the nursing home? I'm like, dang,
we
what
do
the
that
heck?
After every show.
What the heck?
That's where I pick you up and take you back.
First pitch, strike to Keaton.
I don't think Wilmington's going to try to steal here.
I would hope not. Ball gets by or something, then you get him down there. This out one was real low. One ball, one strike to Keaton. Keaton plays a lot of third base for the Hurricane.
Still 47 degrees out.
Ball's hit to the pitcher. She throws it to first.
That's it.
And that's the ball game. So Wilmington today only had no hits and only 2 left on base.
Yeah, tough day for the Hurricane as far as in the first game of this triple-header.
And Wagers throws a no-hitter, a no-no thrown by Wagers. And Williamsburg wins this first game 13-0.
Pretty impressive.
Wow. You can think so. They scored three in the first, four in the third, two in the fourth, and four in the fifth. And, wow, I tell you what, hits. Well, I haven't even counted the last couple of innings. Let's see. Hit there. They had a hitting barrage today. They had 14 hits. So they scored 13 runs on 14 hits.
How many home runs? One?
Just well, there was one home run, and one girl got the home, but it was the error on the right fielder.
Right.
Had one triple, had a couple doubles. Probably if that had started the game, it would be Gullett. Gullett was 3-for-3. She almost hit for the cycle. She had a home run, a double, a base hit, and then got hit by pitch and scored four times. Scored four times. So that one's in the books, folks. Game one of three. And this next game, I believe it's going to be the Williamsburg Wildcats. And we're not sure who's home or anything like that yet.
Right.
Williamsburg Wildcats versus the Leesburg Fairfield Lions. So, Rick, what are we going to tell everybody? Probably be back in about 1 o'clock, half hour or so?
I think the actual starting time is right there on our website. I think that it may be 1 o'clock, so we might be on the air at 12:45. We usually come on about 15 minutes, maybe 10 minutes in this instance. But we'll take a break here, and what we'll say is just keep a lookout. We'll be back on the air here shortly with the game number two of this triple header.
All right. See you in a few, people.